work out to.
My blessing, sorry, why so
dark?
Okay. To answer the netizen question, untuk menjawab pertanyaan netizen, okay, before we pray first, yeah? Okay, let's we pray. Krista? Krista, thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please protect our bodies, our spirit, our family with your blood until we arrive in destinations. We want to study English. Please bless our trip, our family, our bestie, our man and on site, even our haters, watcher, visitor. God bless all of them with your love. Thank you for we pray in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Okay, this is the question, kan? Ada pertanyaan from netizen. I read in the YouTube. She said like this. Oh, the Christian like that. The Christian is like that. Oh, orang Kristen kayak gitu ya. Their lifestyle, gaya hidupnya. Maybe he look at that's a rich man, right? Mungkin dia melihat itu orang kaya. Every day with the luxury. Setiap hari dengan hal-hal kemewahan. Eating, shopping, drinking, and then walking, buying, shopping. Well, that's good. Look at that. Okay. The mansion in heaven is like that. Okay. Emang orang Kristen gaya hidupnya seperti itu ya, gitu. Berarti kan dia Muslim mungkin atau agama lain ya. Ajaran Kristen begitu ya. Emang orang Kristen begitu ya kan? Jadi katanya emang orang Kristen ajarannya begitu ya. Oke. Okay. Oh, kita we explain one by one. Kita jelaskan dulu satu-satu. All the bestie can know. Semua bestie bisa tahu. If you want to read the Bible, kalau bestie-bestie mau baca Bible. Bible kan basic instructions before leaving earth. Bible itu kan dasar petunjuk sebelum meninggalkan bumi. Oke. Okay. According to your questions, kalau untuk menurut pertanyaan Anda, you can read in the Bible. You can know by yourselves. Bestie bisa baca sendiri Bible itu Alkitab. What is or you can type in the Google, boleh klik di Google. Kristen artinya apa? Orang Kristen artinya apa? Like that. All the people can know from the Google. Okay. So, what is the meaning of Christian? Jadi apa artinya Kristen? Kristen dulu ya. Kalau orang kan, ya orang lah ya, orang. Saya orang, basic juga orang, people kan. Christian people, orang Kristen. So, the meaning of Christian is the follower of Jesus Christ. Jadi arti Kristen saja kan pengikut Kristus. The follower of Jesus Christ. Jadi arti Kristen itu adalah pengikut Kristus. Oke. Okay? Jadi arti Kristen itu adalah pengikut in Jesus name, darah Yesus. OMG. Darah Yesus lindungi kami. Okay, kita berdoa ya. Oh, in Jesus name, in batu ampar like that. Okay, in the name of Jesus Christ, we reject all the accident spirit, that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. OMG. We still in batu ampar. Kami masih di batu ampar. I continue again. Saya sambung lagi ya. So, the meaning of Christian kan jadi artinya Kristen itu artinya bestie, netizen yang bertanya artinya pengikut Kristus ya. Ya, jadi dia harus ikut Kristus. Kristus itu apa? Yesus waktu hidup di bumi, Jesus Christ is God. Yesus kan Tuhan. He was born as a man, dia lahir sebagai manusia. He live simple life. Dia kan hidup sederhana. Even he is the owner heaven and earth. Sekalipun kan dia yang punya surga dan bumi. Even he is the creator heaven and earth. Sekalipun dia yang menciptakan semuanya, even he is the creator in Colossians chapter 1 verse 16. Sekalipun di dalam Kolose pasal 1 ayat 16, that the Bible say, Alkitab berkata, he is the creator, dia pencipta, visible, invisible, yang kelihatan dan yang tidak kelihatan, heaven and earth, langit dan bumi, all dominion, semua kerajaan. And what again? Man, angel, power, kuasa, the government, pemerintahan in heaven and on this earth. He is the creator. He is only the one. He is only one the creator. Dia sendiri yang menciptakan segalanya. Okay? He is the owner of heaven and earth. You know heaven and earth, so many mountain, gold mountain, pure mountain, yang punya gunung-gunung emas. When he lives on this earth, ketika dia hidup di bumi, what he's done, apa yang dia lakukan? He lives simple. Dia hidupnya sederhana. Okay? So, the meaning of the Christian, if we want to know, the follower of Jesus Christ must live like Jesus Christ, harus hidup seperti Kristus. That's why his disciple, his follower, his believer, itu sebabnya orang yang percaya kepada dia, his follower, pengikutnya, and his disciple, murid-muridnya, live simple life, hidup sederhana. Hidup sederhana. Okay? Like our pastor, seperti Bapak Gembala kami, Pastor Isaac Leo Lewi Santoso, Pendeta Isaac Leo Lewi Santoso, he live simple. All his richness, all the treasure and the richness who come to the church, semua kekayaan yang ada di gereja itu use for the sake of kingdom of God, semuanya digunakan untuk kepentingan kerajaan surga. All the money, all the treasure, semuanya digunakan untuk kepentingan kerajaan surga. And this pastor live simple. Pastor ini hidup dengan sederhana. Like my papi also, papi saya juga seperti itu. Okay, so that's decision, itu adalah keputusan. Everyone can choose live simple, setiap orang bisa hidup sederhana. Or everyone, all the rich men, atau semua all the rich men, atau semua orang kaya, all the blessed men and women, ataupun semua orang yang diberkati, laki-laki dan perempuan, they can live as their choose. Mereka bisa hidup sesuai pilihan mereka. Like in Luke chapter 16, seperti Lukas 16, right? Semuanya according to our decision, semuanya tergantung dengan pilihan kita. But God will reward, Tuhan yang akan memberi upah. So, Bible say, if we want God knows us, kalau kita mau Tuhan mengenal kita, we must do his commandment, kita harus lakukan kehendaknya. Not our own will, bukan kehendak kita, but his will, Jesus Christ will, kehendak Tuhan. We must live like Jesus Christ live, kita harus hidup seperti Yesus. Every day, he just doing good, setiap hari dia hanya berbuat baik. He heals the people, dia menyembuhkan. He ministry the people, dia melayani. He teach the church, dia mengajar gereja. He teach his disciple, dia mengajar murid-muridnya. And then he gives the food, dia memberikan makan. All the days in his life, seluruh kehidupannya, seumur hidup, he only doing the good thing, dia hanya melakukan yang baik to all the people. And his commandment same ya, in Old Testament and the New Testament, perintahnya tuh tetap sama ya. In Old Testament, di perjanjian lama, loving God with all our heart, soul, spirit, strength, mengasihi Tuhan dengan segenap hati, jiwa, kekuatan, akal, budi, and love the others, dan mengasihi sesama. Loving God first, mengasihi Tuhan yang terutama, loving God, not with your mouth, bukan dengan mulut, but with all you have, tapi dengan semua yang Anda miliki, your body, your soul, your spirit, your mind, segenap hidup, hati, jiwa, kekuatan, with all your money, dengan semua uangmu, with all your healthiness, dengan semua kesehatanmu, with all your treasure, dengan segala hartamu, with all your knowledge, dengan segala ilmu pengetahuanmu, you present to God, persembahkan untuk Tuhan, use for the sake of kingdom of God, gunakan untuk kepentingan kerajaan surga. And then preach gospel, beritakan Injil, share the word of God, until yourself and your family become Cornelius family, sampai seluruh keluargamu and my family become like Cornelius family, like that, until they can become the disciple of Jesus Christ, sampai semua mereka bisa menjadi murid Kristus. Not church participant, bukan peserta kebaktian, but disciple of Jesus Christ, tapi seperti murid Kristus. Okay, we are already in Jodo, and this is GSDA Church, Assembly of God Church. This is Assembly of God Church in here, in Jodo Besti. Okay, Thessalonian Church, fear of the Lord. Okay,
This is the school. Okay, thank you, bestie. We want to study English. See you in the next video. God bless. God bless. God bless. Bella Kitty, yes. Thank you for watching. See you. Bye-bye. Yes, in here. Take the money. See you. Let's study English.